Ownership and scopes are especially important to keep in mind when we are passing values between Rust functions. Let's consider this code, which creates the say variable in our main function, and the value of that variable is a string. And we have a second function, which takes a string and prints it out. When I pass the value of the say variable to the second function, I transfer ownership of the value to that function. Once I transfer ownership, the variable is now out of scope in my main function. If I try to access the value of the say variable in my main function after it has been transferred, I receive an error. The compiler catches that I'm trying to access a value whose ownership has been transferred somewhere else. Are there other ways we could handle passing this string so that its ownership is not moved to the second function? Yes, and we will cover those in detail in the next video. Before that, let's review these rules of ownership one more time. Each value in Rust has a variable that is called its owner. There can only be one owner at a time. When the owner goes out of scope, the value will be dropped. These rules are how the Rust compiler prevents you from unintentionally creating memory safety bugs in your code. Now that we have an overview of ownership, let's move on to our related concept, borrowing. I'll see you in the next video.